Have you seen the post on Reddit that claim you to be truthful? No. In the summary of the cycle so far, that they've used ETFs to dodge GEX, creating FTDs. Now they use ETFs again while clearing FTDs to keep the price low, creating more FTDs later. No. They used ETFs to dodge GEX, and those FTDs have yet to be realized. There's no evidence of them using ETFs to clear ETF FTDs. That's like trying to pay a credit card off with a credit card. That's not going to work. If you use the same ETF to clear FTDs, right, you're going to drive the price of the ETF up, which makes creation more expensive. That doesn't work. You can't. So right now what they're doing is they have low volume FTDs and they're internalizing a lot. And so right now they can use puts to stabilize momentum. They can get the MM to act on their behalf. This isn't sustainable. First of all, when those internalized buy orders dump, it's going to pressure this put position. We saw their put position get blown out yesterday. They lost a lot of money on that. And every time they do this, they risk a ton of capital in order to maintain these puts. And any buy pressure outside of them, any interest comes in, a pension fund, a large bank, anybody puts buy pressure on the stock while they're covering, and this whole position can blow up. So it's working for them in the short term, but it's not a sustainable strategy. So this morning short buy puts cover, this isn't sustainable. You can't continue to do this while they internalize their own buy pressure for short net short FTDs. Like this has to come to fruition. It's not infinitely sustainable. They can't do it forever. The puts they're buying don't even aren't even like a long time frame. Like they're just buying fucking weekly puts. It's super unstable, and the stock is volatile enough that, they can just lose the millions they put into puts every morning in a few ticks, one gap up. I mean, look what happened yesterday morning when they tried to like pull those puts at the last possible second. And the price just blew through it up to 136. That's the risk they take by trying to do this. And their hope is that they can cover enough of the FTDs that when they do dump the internalized orders to the market, they can pull their puts and let it rip, and they don't have to cover FTDs at that higher price point. The question is, will they be able to facilitate their strategy or not? How many different FTD positions are operating behind the scenes here? We have market maker FTDs, we have short hedge fund FTDs, we have whoever owns those fucking futures contracts FTDing. And we don't know if those are in sync, right? And so the more layers of FTDs that we're getting coming in, the more or the higher probability that, one of those does not move in line with the others. And once that starts happening, it becomes chaos. And it's been the same scenario every time. Every one of our dips has played out essentially the same way over the last year, almost year and a half, 6 quarters. The Feb 18 320 worth buying. I mean, I'm Feb 28 320. That's like a really weird date and strike. What's the logic behind that, Josh? And you got to remember that this isn't just GameStop. They're doing this across an entire sector. So like, sure, the cost to just suppress the price of GameStop is probably maybe even something they can manage, right? But to do it across multiple ETFs, to do it across all of, you know, fucking consumer discretionary, that's expensive. That's really, really expensive. You need to think about like the bigger picture here and focus, not to draw focus away from GameStop, but to understand what GameStop means in relation to the rest of this massive short position. The DTCC is a regulatory agency. They're a self-regulating regulatory agency. They're not... They're just an SRO. You're giving them too much power and credit.